This is the SAP Developer News for the 30th of May, 2024. There are two great events taking place next week. One, of course, is Sapphire, and the other is an awesome multi-conference event called Code Connect 2024, taking place in Germany. Running Monday through Thursday, there's an SAP Code Jam on service integration with CAP. Then there's Recap, the conference for all things SAP Cloud Application Programming Model. Then there's UI5Con for all things SAP UI5 and OpenUI5. Then there's ABAPConf 2024 Europe for ABAP developers by ABAP developers. And the best thing, if you can't attend in person, then there are live streams of the sessions and tracks available for each of the Recap, UI5Con and ABAPConf conferences. And for the live streams, there's no registration required. If you are lucky enough to be able to attend in person, remember that it's not all develop. Well, mostly it is. As well as the awesome hallway track, there's yoga sessions, massage chairs, an unofficial meetup on Monday evening in Casa Nostra. I quite like the fact that it's Italian, given the flavour of the CAP documentation. And also, don't forget to install the app for the Recap conference. All the details, including where to catch the live streams, are on the individual conference websites, which are all themselves linked from the umbrella codeconnect.dev. See you there.
Hola, SAP developers. Generally, there's a lot happening in the SAP integration suite. Fortunately, Gabriela recently published a blog post in SAP Community where she highlights the different updates that there have been to the different capabilities of SAP Integration Suite. For example, in cloud integration, in API management, in the B2B integration, in edge integration cell. So make sure to check out her blog post to see what has happened lately. Also, in case you missed it, we recently announced the first ever SAP Code Jam Roadshow in Latin America. My colleague, Josh Bentley, and I will be doing two topics in this roadshow, which are event-driven integrations with SAP Integration Suite Advanced Event Mesh and SAP Build, Create Apps and Processes Without Code. Now, our first stop will be in Sao Paulo, Brazil, the 8th and 9th of August. Then it will be Santiago, Chile, the 12th and 13th of August. Then the 15th and 16th of August will be in Buenos Aires, Argentina, and we'll be finalized the roadshow in Bogota, Colombia, the 20th and 21st of August. I look forward to meeting you guys over there. See ya.
Hello, everyone. Multiple customers ask us time and again how they can make use of all the features in SAP Fiori in SAP S/4HANA to manage their UX adoption journey. SAP S/4HANA Customer Care and Regional Implementation Group provide a free hands-on experience bootcamp called 5 Steps to Fiori. This will help you define your UX adoption strategy and gain practical hands-on skills in activities, technologies, and tools to adopt SAP Fiori UX. This bootcamp is offered only for SAP customers, and each customer is required to participate as a team. New sessions for Q2 2024 are now listed in the program information document. This offering now includes content on SAP S/4HANA Embedded Analytics. The link to the documentation is in the description below.
If you're a developer in the SAP ecosphere and are looking for a reason to jump into the exciting and open world of the Fediverse, there's a great reason in the form of the SAP version bot that toots, that's tweets in old money, timely new release information on SAP related NPM packages and GitHub repositories that it monitors for us. I follow the SAP version bot from my Mastodon account, and it helps me keep up to date with what's new in the CAP Node.js and UI5 worlds. Grab yourself an account over in the Fediverse and start following this bot.
Did you know the Avant Cloud Developer Trial 2022 is now available as a Docker image? We know many of you have been waiting for a local Avant instance that fully supports Avant RESTful Application Programming Model. So, to pull this image, simply copy the Docker pull command to the command line. The pull operation will take some time, but eventually it will succeed, and the image will be viewable in the Docker Desktop's Image tab. Next, it's time to get the Docker container. Use the following commands provided on the Docker site and watch the output carefully. You should now be able to click on the A4H, and the Logs tab should show the same information. Next, we're going to set up the SAFQE connection and log into developers. The SAP system is now up and running, and as you can see, it's visible in Eclipse. For a deeper dive into specifics, including the features and the release highlights, check out Julie Homer's blog post. This post also provides links to further information on Avant Cloud and its accessibility. Be sure to secure your Avant Cloud developer trial now.